the training in monasteries in Cumann, where I prepare Kursigistas, the Legion of Mary, the Blue Army, many of these militant organizations. I train and prepare how they can become Baptists, how they can become Adventists, how they can become Methodists, how they can become Presbyterian, how they can become Pentecostal, in all these areas where they most infiltrate any area. Infiltration of churches and religious institutions as well as government that cover a tremendous number of institutions.
And the purpose of that infiltration was what for?
Well, the purpose is what the Roman Catholic system has all the time as her own purpose, is to infiltrate, to penetrate all the areas of life where the Roman Catholic can have control and access for the coming world government. What that means is, in preparation for that world government, the Roman Catholic institution, especially since the establishment of the Jesuit order in 1541, throughout all these 500 years, they've been in preparation and through infiltration and penetration of every level of society, in order to take over the world politically and religiously.
When the Council of Trent occurred, it was controlled by the Jesuits.
Yes.
How about the Vatican II?
Now, there a connection there? Yes, the connection is very, very, very prophetic. I will say this, I think that will clear the whole point here, because it's so prophetic that while the Council of Trent was the first council to be managed by the Jesuit order, the Vatican Council was brought about by the same Jesuit order with the same intention. And you know the intention of the Council of Trent. The intention behind the Council of Trent was the Counter-Reformation. What was the intent of the Vatican Council II? Another Counter-Reformation, but called today, how you call it? Renewal. You see the point? Now, the change was a name, but the intentions were the same.
Yes.
See, more sophisticated today.
Yes.
You see, the Counter-Reformation was taken through the Council of Trent. That was, the entire Counter-Reformation was performed by the Council of Trent decrees. Then through that time, until today, Vatican Council II came about with the idea of renewal. That means another step forward, and the final, I will say this is the final stage of a Counter-Reformation.
Now, how about the charismatic movement? What's the connection with that?
The charismatic movement is serving the purpose, as we said, of one of the many issues. As we said about Saturdays and Sunday, they'll pick up every issue with different denominations. And in the case of the charismatic movement, they pick up the charismatic movement because one factor. they could not bring under subjection the Pentecostal denominations.
They couldn't.
They could not. Even when they went to the ecumenical movement before, from 1945 down to our day, since this already starts. As a matter of fact, if you want to know, the World Council of Churches started by financed by the Jesuits in Europe in 1945, after the end of the Second World War already, or by the time that the World War was to end, already the Jesuits were at work trying to unite all the Protestants in Europe. And that was the origin of the World Council of Churches and the ecumenical movement. Today, the charismatic movement is serving that purpose. Where a Pentecostal could not be bring into the ecumenical forum, they brought it through the exercise of a charismatic gift.
それぞれの宗教の慣習に従って左右に